to the light on it.
All right, tell us what.
Slept this nigga ass. Y'all know how it is, a sleeping nigga?
Tell me.
You know how it is, a nigga.
You was bumper. About to sleep right now.
Listen to me. Slept this nigga ass. Slept, drop, stop, rep said
three times, up. Three times.
One round, second round.
I got Unc as a coach in the corner.
Yes.
The 11th round, we thought it was over.
Hey, stay on the light right there, right there.
We thought it was over. The ref said, oh shit, oh, you ready, Tony? Tony said, I don't know. He said, well, I'm gonna give you a chance, bitch. That's what the ref said to him. The ref said, I'm gonna give you a chance, bitch. It's really over. It's really over, but I fuck with
don't
you.
Don't yell too much.
I fuck with you.
Take it down.
I'm gonna give you a chance. When it should have been a 10 count, he gave him a 9.5. Let him go back out there.
Your seatbelt,
and then slap the nigga ass again.
I really beat him. I really did.
It was over. Yeah, we all getting up over everybody. The whole fucking arena is over. He stopped the fight. The ref said, oh no, come on, get back in there. And then slept the nigga ass again. Mm-hmm. Which we was already up 95-93 in the 11th round. We were already up. But we said, you know what? Fuck the judges.
Fuck them.
No matter where they from.
Amen.
Already.
And we went in there and slept a nigga ass. Yeah,
hurt again by the hook.
Didn't land cleanly, but buckled him right there. That
ringside with the lines. Can't stop, now we on fire. Letting you inside, showing you how we ride. Phone wheels we drive, hoping you feel inspired. Work hard, don't get tired, every day stay on your grind. They don't know all the things I've been through. I got me and my fam, what about you? Untraditional with all my moves. You are now ringside with the king of family too, yeah. I ain't forget about the days it rained on us. Now we in the league and lines only I trust. Now them diamonds flooding and shining on us. Too high in the air, can't hear what they say about us. Follow my life day to day. I bet you see that it's safe to say that I'm a king, it ain't about things, it's all about the way I paved the way.
My wife toasted too.
She ain't got no sense.
Thank you.
five. Like, but I mean, we fought through everything. Like mom said, we had so many bumps in the road. Not as much as last camp, but I mean, we waited a whole year for this day. Like a whole year. We had blood, sweat, and tears. We're finally here, and like he finally gets to get back like what he worked so hard for, 20 years in boxing, and I'm just thankful to like witness it with him and be by his side with it. And I love you, and I'm gonna get this W tonight.
I'm down, but I'm ready to do the ding ding ding.
No, I just want to say, like, I know you're thanking us, but I thank you for just letting me be a part of this moment. Like I said, talk about moments. I'm just honored to be here right now, just to share this experience with us. Like, this is a special moment. We can talk about this and be about this forever. You know what I mean? So this moment in time right now, let's take advantage of it. Let's enjoy it. Let's give our all, like we've all been doing. Just make sure we help. And my brother, like I said, my brother, you know, do what he gotta do when we go out there and get that done. Like you said, hey, just stay determined.
So, a lot of people here know we have four kids. So Titus came to me and said, "Babe, Mel wanted me to come do camp." I said, "Who's gonna take care of kids?" And then I looked at him and I saw how excited he was for being part of what you built. And I said, "We're gonna make it work." So he came. It's been a sacrifice for years. I'm so glad that he was able to be a part of this thing with you. You are an amazing person. You deserve the world. We were in the car, started from the bottom, and now you're here, came home. All I thought about was when we was in San Antonio and Dallas, was making them road trips. And you're here, cousin. You deserve all the blessings. You deserve all the happiness. Amen.
I met Mel when he was 12.
Oh, junior high.
Yeah, this is fifth grade.
Oh, elementary.
Yeah. Now that's intermediate school.
But you were 12 and fifth grade?
Oh, lucky man.
I don't know how old that was. I was in the fifth grade. I met him. Him and his brother came. They had the little braids in the head. No hang time. We've just been real cool since then. Even if we don't talk for like 3, 4, 5 months sometimes, we come back together and we talk like me and Mr. Beeski. We don't skip a beat. You know what I'm saying? I understand him. Over the years, I learned the type of person that he was. At first, I kind of misunderstood him a little bit, but it took me some time to get to know him. I remember when he turned pro, he was in North Gym at Hastings in high school. He came up to me and he was excited, "Bro, turn a pro. And in my head, you know, I don't know too much about boxing at that time, so I'm like, "Turn a pro, what is this guy talking about?" And he's like, "Bro, I'm turning pro, I'm finna be a pro athlete or whatever." So then I'm like, "All right, cool." So then he was fighting, he was like 3-0. And then he called me, he was like, "Bro, I'm 3-0. Then he came 4-0, 5-0. And I remember one time he was walking in the mall, and he had put some shades on his eyes. I don't know if he's gonna remember this, but he put some shades on his eyes. So then I was like, "All right, bro, what you think, you're a celebrity or something?" He was like, "I'm telling you, Kevin, one day I'm gonna be the world champion." And I was kind of like, "Damn," you know, I still think about it to this day. I'm like, "Damn." Then I remember his times where we drove to his fight all the way to like Mexico and McAllen. He didn't have no nothing. It's me, him. We're in the hotel room, and he's like, "Damn." He's like, "Damn, bro." He's like, "Damn, bro, I can't wait. It can't come any faster. And then I just tell him, like, you know, take your time. And then he goes through his things that he was going through his life. We talking about it and everything like that. But he never stopped. He never stopped, like, pushing himself. Even if nobody's around him, he'll still get the work done. There's times when he'll go to Savannah. He used to come pick me up in the morning at, like, 7 o'clock. He still does it because he just left me to go to the airport. He still does it. He pulled up and he called me, and I woke up with like 5 missed calls. I'm like, "Damn, all right, let me hurry up." And I called him. He was like, "Bro, you didn't answer the phone. I left you." I'm like, "Damn, he left me." He still does it. He still does the same thing to me. We still got the same relationship. So, he won the world title against Jackson. I was there. Just like a lot of things that he does in his life, I feel like he picks up the phone before he makes like major decisions. He'll pick up the phone and he'll call me and he'll give my advice and we'll talk about it. And things like that. And I tell my girl all the time, like, I don't have friends. You know what I'm saying? I don't have a lot of friends. I keep my, I distance myself a lot of times, you know, but I consider him like a brother to me. If I need anything, whether it's advice, whether it's anything I need from him, I know he's there. I can call him, answer the phone for me. You know what I'm saying? His heart is very pure. I know I'm long, I don't talk much, but his heart is very pure. His heart is very pure. And, shit, you know, I don't talk, but, I mean, you know what you gotta do tonight, man. You know what it is.
So what I was trying to think about, like everybody going around, like what I was gonna say, because there's so much to say about you, especially for me. I ain't got no brothers, you feel me? But one thing I realized about everybody, what they said about you, was what I got out of it was you always open yourself up to people. You always, from day one, when I ain't even know you, like you opened yourself up to me and you trusted me. You gave me everything you had, so I feel obligated to give you everything that I have. And it's way deeper than boxing, bro. That's what I noticed too about everybody. It's way deeper than just a title. It's way deeper than all that, man. You family, bro. It's been many times that we just stood in the studio 3 o'clock in the morning, and me and it had been me and you. And that's all you ever wanted, and I always respected that about you. I believe in you so much, bro. You keep proving yourself even every time to me. I love you. I'm going to do everything I can for you, bro. You know what I'm saying? You already know what you're going to do tonight. And, you know, we're going to celebrate, bro. It's a big night for you. But you got it, though. You know you got it, bro. Like I said, man.
So, I wasn't around
connected everybody is and how much love, like, and to know the love with between you guys is like, it's crazy. Like, when I see how much love they share for you, like, I know that's like true. And like, I know I can speak for like a lot of us, like, we weren't here for the camp, but after Joanne was keeping us updated like every day, like, and like, I swear, like, the 10 weeks we couldn't wait to be here. And like, I know we all proud of you, man. We respect you and we just hope the best. That's what tonight, man.
Success.
thank you for this experience, bro. Like Ron said, if you come here, tell me, come here, you know. So,
second fight, huh?
Yeah. So, congratulations. I know you'll get that win, bro.
Yes, sir.
Hey, man, I met you when I was 17, so you was probably 14, 15. And one thing about you, at that point, when I first met you, he was like, oh yeah, we box. I'm like, man, you like this big, bro, who you boxing? He was like, man, I'm gonna be the champ one day. So I was like, you always had that swag. You knew from then what you had to do to get there. So tonight ain't gonna be nothing for you, because you, from, hey, I tell everybody, oh, he had that swag. He's like, man, your cousin got that swag. I was like, my wife love you. She talking, she like, my cousin, we watch you on TV, she's right here. I be like, man, step back so everybody can watch. So much love, brother. Best of luck to you.
Take the power that I got. I'm appreciative of everybody that's been in camp with me. You know what I'm saying? Like,
even getting hurt, even through injuries, just whatever we went through, you know, we made it out of that.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And it's like, I think I'm headstrong, I'm focused, just put me in there and I can get the job done. I'm excited. Like, it's my team. We celebrate every time. This is starting to become a rhythmatic thing. How we went in there and destroyed Coda, just got to get our mind right. You know, feel that vibe, get the lights under us, and I think I got it tonight.
We know
tonight,
you got it.
We know you got it.
I'm willing to do everything I can in this little moment. You know what I'm saying? Got 36 minutes. Every time, every round gotta be one round at a time. We know I need y'all to be lit up, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Get the best advice. Convince some judges. We'll never know what to expect. You know what I'm saying? But I know that, like, I feel like the whole world of boxing, the whole world, outside world, could be against me. Even if it's people like Al Heyman, the people that's spending the big bags on these promoters, anybody that smile on your face, they really not with you. They want to see the failure because of how hyped up this is. But the team that is with you is the ones that I look around every day, the ones that's with me, the ones that's in this room. We in this thing together. So we're going to go in there and have our business tonight. I promise you, we ain't going to be doing all them jabs.
Yeah.
We're going to cut that down. We shift over. I'm going to move, get comfortable, get in position. And then if I can connect faithfully, he's going to be all right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
In the house, yeah.
I never had it. You know you gotta go get your nothing. Kind of shade. I gotta hold that thing up and it grew.
So who sings this song? Who sings this song? Or is it too young for you? Like,
it's too young. What?
The Beatles is like more your era.
Beatles, that's way, way, way before me.
Who is in your
it's
era?
It's Chris Brown, but it's featuring somebody else. Who is it featuring? How about that?
Do you know?
Oh my goodness. You asked a question. What a question?
Mm-hmm. I'm glad you know Chris Brown.
I don't know him.
No, the artist. I know you don't know him personally.
No, never saw him. Never saw the album cover. Mm-hmm. That's not here, not there.
He's like a.
You do not know who the artist is. Here. How about that?
What does why? Why does it matter?
Because you didn't know who.
Do you know? I'm okay. Do you know? I don't know who's the artist.
I don't know either.
So what was the purpose of arguing with
I'm
me about that?
I'm trying to find out who it was. I thought you might have knew something.
You can look it up. Do you have Shazam? Do you know what Shazam is?
No. I can look it up.
What are you going to type in? Chris Brown song?
No. who features on the song? This song with Chris Brown?
Then you can come up with like almost like 1,000 songs.
I can't say the name of this song.